Good morning. Can the God Chemosh save Moab? Our reading today is at Jeremiah chapter 48, verses 11 to 20. Moab has been at ease from his youth. He has settled on his dregs and has not been emptied from vessel to vessel, nor has he gone into captivity. Therefore, his taste remained in him, and his scent has not changed. Therefore, behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, that I shall send him wine workers who will tip him over and empty his vessels and break the bottles. Moab shall be ashamed of Chemosh, as the house of Israel was ashamed of Bethel, their confidence. How can you say, we are mighty and strong men for the war? Moab is plundered and gone up from her cities. Her chosen young men have gone down to the slaughter, says the king, whose name is the Lord of hosts. The calamity of Moab is near at hand, and his affliction comes quickly. Bemoan him, all you who are around him, and all you who know his name. Say how the strong staff is broken, the beautiful rod. O daughter inhabiting Dibon, come down from your glory and sit in thirst, for the plunderer of Moab has come against you. He has destroyed your strongholds. O inhabitant of Aroer, stand by the way and watch. Ask him who flees and her who escapes. Say, what has happened? Moab is shamed, for he is broken down. Wail and cry, tell it in Arnon, that Moab is plundered. So now in those days, each nation sort of had its preferred god or gods, and the god of Moab was the god Chemosh. We know somewhat about him and a lot that we don't know, but we do know that human sacrifices were sometimes done for him. In 2 Kings 3, for example, the king of Moab was in a battle and things weren't going too well. So what did he do? He took his eldest son, you know, the one who would be king after him if he wasn't killed, and he had him slain as a human sacrifice to the god Chemosh in an attempt to appease Chemosh so that they would win that really important battle. I guess it was more important, you know, I guess what did the father say? Sorry, son, but you know, you've got to take one for the team. But anyway, the god Chemosh was somewhat like Baal, and we can see a pretty awful human sacrifices were a piece that was there for him. So in our reading, verse 13 was quite interesting because of a comparison that it made. Again, here's what it says. Moab shall be ashamed of Chemosh, as the house of Israel was ashamed of Bethel, their confidence. What's this business about Bethel? Well, Jeroboam was the king of the northern kingdom, the 10 northern tribes called the Kingdom of Israel. He noticed that, you know, people were always going to the southern kingdom because Jerusalem was located in the southern kingdom, and for worship he had to go up to Jerusalem three times a year. He didn't like this too well. There was a big animosity between the northern and southern kingdoms there, and so Jeroboam had a brilliant idea. He would make two golden calves and set them up in some of the cities he has there and tell the people, don't go to Jerusalem anymore for worship. You come to these cities where we've set up the golden gods. These are the gods that delivered you from Egypt. So he did it. And of course, you can imagine this became a terrible snare, an immorality and a snare, these fake gods. So in our reading, verse 13 compares the false worship of the god Chemosh of the Moabites with the false worship of the two golden calves that King Jeroboam set up in northern Israel in Bethel. You can read about that story in 1 Kings 12, verse 28. As always, false gods and fake gods become a source of false worship and trouble and immorality. And it wasn't any different for the 10 northern tribes. It wasn't any different for anyone. It wasn't any different for Moab. And now judgment's coming upon Moab. Can the fake god Chemosh save them? No matter how hard they tried, the Moabite defenders come across here as being slaughtered and destroyed on their own mountains. Their young men, their mighty warriors, the best they had would be slain, and that's just the way it is. Can Chemosh deliver? No, Chemosh can't do anything. Chemosh doesn't even exist as a real entity. He's just a fake god. A brilliant idea, an idea of Satan, which suited the Moabites pretty well for a while. And so very sad here. We've got to avoid all these fake and false gods because they turn us in the same awful direction. Dear Father in heaven, we recognize that fake gods are traps. They're no use to us. They're no help to us. Help us to instead follow you, the one true and living God. You're the hope we have, nothing else. So bless us and keep us, watch over us, Lord. You be our keeper and our protector. Obviously, these fake gods like Chemosh can't protect anyone. So Lord, help us to learn this lesson well. And be so glad that you are our helper and our protector. Oh, Lord, help us not to be like that. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Can the god Chemosh save the Moabites? No, of course not. But the living God, the God of heaven, can surely save you and I. Oh, let's trust in him. God be with you today.